my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies for Bedford TV. And today's episode of The Review is a big one. Not necessarily too long, I'll try and keep it to myself, but this is one that I've been looking forward to for probably 11 years. I will tell you what, Avengers Endgame did it. I am super excited to talk about it today, and before we get to that, I'm just a little bit about me and the show. If you have watched The Review before, you know that I always do my best to avoid all major spoilers. I am going to do it. I am not going to give away any of the major plot points in Endgame. I'm going to do a completely spoiler-free review. Wish me luck. What I will also do is provide my recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it, stay home and stream it, or skip it in every episode of The Review. And this is definitely a movie to go see. I guess that's a spoiler. I kind of like spoiled myself for the end of this video, but just hang on and let me make my case. As you may know, I am a comic book fan, especially comic book stories and comic book movies. And if we're talking about comic book movies, what I pretty much mean is we're talking about the MCU. The Marvel Cinematic Universe is 22 movies deep, including Endgame, and we made it. We got here. I almost feel like it's like, if you're old like I am, we always heard about the end of the Mayan calendar. It was this thing that was like so far off that maybe we'll get there someday. We have heard about Endgame for so long and knew that it was coming that when I eventually was sitting in the theater waiting for it to start, it was like an incredible feeling. It was really something like of a community. Like, I was in a bustling theater. This movie broke so many records the weekend that it came out. Every seat was taken, and we were all in it together. We were ready to go on this wild ride. That was April 26th. This movie, like I said, broke every record for an opening box office thing that you could possibly imagine. Biggest movie of all time. And it probably deserved it too, because there had been 21 movies coming to this point. Now, Avengers Endgame has some things going for it that are a little hard to deal with. If you have watched The Review before, you know that I often talk about how under 100 minutes is a sweet spot for a movie. If a movie is 90 minutes or less, that is a selling point unto itself for me. Avengers Endgame is 3 hours and 1 minute long. It is maybe the longest movie I've seen in theaters in the last couple of years, probably the longest movie that anyone else has seen in theaters potentially in their whole life. And while I do think that they do an amazing job of justifying that runtime, since it's been out, I've been talking with other people about this movie, and while I went in prepared, I had done the work. I had seen 21 movies, getting ready for it, many of them multiple times. I was amped. And I think that Avengers Endgame is best described as 3 hours and 1 minute of putting a bow on it. They put so many bows on threads that had been just running through the Marvel Cinematic Universe that it was an incredibly satisfying, incredibly referential roller coaster ride. I thought it was super fun. And I think that it could have been downright insufferable if you had not watched 21 movies before this movie had come out to get ready for it. I think if you went into Avengers Endgame cold, it could be 3 hours of what the heck am I doing here? So before you enjoy Avengers Endgame, you have some work to do. If you aren't gonna watch all 21 movies, I think you absolutely wanna watch Avengers 1, Avengers Age of Ultron, and Avengers Infinity War, bare minimum. Those are the ones that you have to see to not think that Avengers Endgame is gratuitously long for no reason. And then, truly, any more than watching just those Avengers movies, treat yourself. They're all good. Even the ones that are bad are good. All of the MCU was worth it. Just treat yourself to watching them. Give yourself some time. Don't really worry about it all being spoiled for you. Yeah, it's a completely 3-hour spoiler fest. But if you haven't put in the time to watch those movies before, you weren't worried about it before, so just take your time, work yourself through the MCU, all the effects hold up in a way that is miraculous, and just treat yourself to Endgame when you're ready for it. Now, if you aren't familiar with the Marvel Cinematic Universe, first of all, you probably are. And then beyond that, it has more or less every A-list performer in Hollywood doing some of their best work. We got Robert Downey Jr., Chris Evans, Mark Ruffalo, Scarlett Johansson, Paul Rudd, Benedict Cumberbatch, Josh Brolin, Brie Larson, Tessa Thompson, to name a few. There are many, many more A-list performers in these movies, and they all do an amazing job because the characters have been given time to grow in a way that we weren't just all of a sudden we had to know everything about them. The reason that Captain America is incredible in Avengers Endgame is because he has earned our knowledge of his character across maybe 10 or 11 appearances in different movies. And it's just so incredible to see something put together so lovingly in a way that just really works off. And I think a big part of the success of this movie is the directing team. Joe and Anthony Russo have directed other entries into the Marvel Cinematic Universe and some of the best entries into the Marvel Cinematic Universe. They did direct Infinity War, the direct sequel to Endgame, as well as Winter Soldier and Civil War 2 and 3 in the Captain America trilogy. Some of the best stuff, some of the most story-intensive parts of the MCU. They did a great job, and also, they directed a number of episodes of Community, a show that was on a couple years ago that is rightfully so put in that cult classic category at this point. And they also, for some fans, put in some Easter eggs for fans of Community into this latest movie. Again, if you've seen it, it's amazing. If you haven't seen it, you're not gonna notice them. And I just think that Endgame was successful and so full of spoilers that I probably can't say anything else without giving some stuff away. I did rewatch a trailer thinking about I could talk about some of that stuff, but like odds are you've heard from a number of people about how much they either liked or disliked it. And I promise if they didn't like it, they haven't seen very much of the MCU. If you have, you've probably already seen Endgame, and if you haven't, treat yourself. Get out there, be a part of the conversation, be in the community, and see it in theaters. This is a huge movie, huge, wide open spaces, great soundtrack, amazing effects. See it on as big of a screen as you possibly can, because we're probably gonna be watching these movies forever when they're available on the Disney Plus streaming service, which comes out very soon. And I do think that Endgame feels like binging a season of a TV show. It is 3 hours long. It does have that binge quality to it. And I don't think that's a bad thing. And I do think that that is a great sign of more good things to come on the Disney Plus streaming service. Go and see Endgame. I promise it's worth it. Unless you haven't seen the MCU, in which case you have other work to do. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.